Listen. Oh, yeah. The sound is back. But did it sound a little bit different to you? Huh.
Hey guys, how are you all doing? Really, that's just great. You know, I'm doing pretty great today too because Apple finally brought back the iconic Mac startup sound. But the weird thing is it sounds a little bit different than normal, but we'll take a listen to that in a bit and analyze it. For now, let's take a look at how we can actually re-enable the Mac startup sound. First, open the terminal, then enter sudo nvram startupmute equals %00. Hit return, enter your password, then hit return again. Then reboot your Mac and enjoy. And if you want to disable the sound, replace the %00 with %01. Now, if you don't want to use the terminal, DasDude1 released a handy app on his website. Go ahead and download that and run that instead. This will let you turn the sound back on or off without using the command line. You know, I find it kind of amusing that Apple backpedaled in a way and let you re-enable a feature they killed off for years. In fact, when they did kill it off, we did a little history video about the Mac startup sound. And we also said, bring back the bong! So I guess in a way, Apple kind of listened to us? But anyway, if you haven't checked out that history video, do check it out because it's a good one. Anyway, now that we have the sound back, we can be happy again. But like I talked about earlier, it does sound a little bit different. In fact, several of you on Twitter pointed that out to me as well, so it's not just my ears going crazy. So let's compare it and take a listen. Here's the startup sound playing on my 2013 MacBook Pro, which comes with the sound turned on by default. Now here's the sound playing on a 2018 MacBook Pro, which does not have the sound on by default. It sounds a little lower pitch, doesn't it? Is it the different speakers creating this effect? Well, that's what I thought at first, but then I thought maybe not. In fact, if we go into Mac Tracker on the same computer and play the startup sound file, you'll notice it doesn't sound lower pitched. So try it out for yourself, let me know what you think. I know not everybody likes the startup sound, but if you don't like it, you can keep it turned off. I like it, so I'm gonna keep it on, even though I have an older machine and it's already on by default. Whatever. I'm happy, to each his own. Thanks DasDude1 for creating that handy app. Thanks Greg Rutke from Rutke Mods for convincing me to make this video. And thanks Maniac Mike for actually loaning me your computer so I could do this, because I still have this 2013 system. You guys are all great. Thanks for sticking with me, everybody. Catch the Krazy and pass it on.